Dom here with Soundsphere TV with Ryan from SOiL. How are you doing, man? How's the tour been going so far?
Great, can't complain. I think it's a great package of bands. I think it's a great lineup. We had shows, we did Europe, the body of Europe before we came over, and we knew there's going to be certain shows that would be great, and they surprised us and were even better than we thought they were going to be, and the shows that we were kind of wondering about, they blew us away. So, I mean, it's been a great run. So far, every show in the UK has been sold out so far leading up to tonight. So hopefully tonight with the walk-up, the same thing. And you got Head PE, American Head Charge, ourselves, and even the opening band, Wolfborn, is kicking every night. So it's just a great package.
That's really cool. And obviously, you know, great package of bands, Head PE as well. You know, you guys have known each other for a long time now. Have you got any sort of positive memories of maybe like this tour, but also, you know, previous years? Because you guys go back quite a long way. And
you know, the guys, SOiL, yeah, toured with American. They brought American Head Charge over in, I think, 2006. Yeah. But of course, I wasn't with the band, yeah, then. So I don't have any memories really of them, but just this tour alone has been really fun. Just a good group of guys, and good for some laughs every night and every day. And the Head PE guys, you know, like you said, we go way back. We've done two U.S. tours just in the last 2 years with those guys. And so we know each other, you know, very well, and it's always good that when you form those friendships to share the road with people like that, because it makes the road life a lot easier when you get along with the people you're with out here.
Absolutely.
And it's just fortunate enough to be around a lot of good people right now, not just good bands, but good people within the band. So it's been killer out here.
Absolutely. How do you feel like you've changed and developed? Because you've been around quite a bit with different music, you know, experiencing, yeah, different stuff. How do you look back on your own career as a musician and how you've changed over the years to get to this point with SOiL?
I don't know how I got here. I have no idea. Somehow, with all the support, I'm still here 18 years later, and I wake up every morning and wonder how I'm still allowed to do this. And it's because of the people out there that support us and supported myself through the years. You know, I definitely wouldn't be here if it wasn't for that. So, I don't know how I've really changed. I don't think I have. I've always just been a person, kind of a simple-minded little guy that just writes about what I've experienced. And I've done that from day one. I still do it today, 18 years later, professionally. So I don't know if I've changed any. I've definitely had a lot of experiences with my previous 7 years with SOiL and then my 7 years with Drowning Pool. They've probably changed me more personally.
Yeah.
My music writing, my lyric writing, I don't think it's really changed much over the years. I know a lot of people that pick up the new album says it reminds them a lot of what should have came after Scars and Redefined. And I think that's a great thing. You know, I was kind of worried about pleasing some of those old school fans, but after a while I was like, just do what comes naturally, and Hole is that. Hole is just what came natural for us.
Absolutely, and obviously we're going to talk a little bit about Hole as well, but how do you look back on the success of Scars and that whole period of the band's life, I guess?
It's real. I mean, I guess you look back and you think about things that just were supposed to be, and that was definitely, that album, I guess, was that for us. Because it was literally before we went in and recorded the demo, for lack of a better term, the demo that got us the record deal that Scars came out on. I was talked into doing that. We had had some independent releases before that, two EPs and a full length, and just we were really kind of hitting a brick wall industry-wise. Right after that, we kind of had a blowout, and I actually had my truck packed, and I was getting ready to move back to Indiana and call it quits, and Adam is the one that talked me into doing one more demo. And like I said, that was a demo with Halo on it. So, luckily, he talked me into staying, and we did the demo, and we got signed, and we released Scars. Or maybe unluckily, I could have been like a brain surgeon or something. I don't know.
That's a scary thought. That's horrible.
That is true. Well, we're glad you did that, man. And obviously, fast forwarding now to Hole, you know, in terms of the ideas and inspirations that went into that new record, you know, pushing your, you know, in what ways did you push yourself as a musician? I guess the band as a whole to release that, and what were the inspirations and ideas that led to its creation?
We really didn't know what we were going to do. We came over here actually to do the 10th anniversary of Scars anniversary tour. Excuse me. And we had no thought of getting back together for an album. At least I know that I didn't. And talking to them, they don't seem to have. And we're just doing that one tour. I was still in Drowning Pool at the time. And after we did that tour, I was at my 7 year mark, and if anybody knows anything about me, I was married for 7 years. The relationship before my marriage was a 7 year long relationship. I was in SOiL for 7 years, and I was at that 7 year mark with Drowning Pool, and the industry was wearing on me, and I just felt like I really didn't know what I wanted to do anymore, like when I left SOiL. And it was just my time, you know, I left Drowning Pool, and we started talking more and more, me and Adam and Tim, and started talking about kind of what we wanted to do musically, more business-wise musically than just musically. we knew we've been a band that's always done just what came natural. So it wasn't so much about what kind of, you know, what kind of album do you want to do. It was more of a, if we did another record, how do you want to handle it business-wise? Do you want to sign with another label? Do you want? And we were all on the same page. We didn't want some shirt and tie in New York City telling us to turn left when we knew we needed to turn right, or felt like we needed to turn right. We were sick, you know, how many years we'd spent underneath someone else's thumb telling us what to do. So we knew if we did another record, we wanted to do it on our own. And that kind of stoked the fire. Because that's something I'd never been a part of, dealing with all the ins and outs behind the scenes of an album. We got to handpick those people and make sure that the people that we had known through the years that we'd had in the industry were the ones that were on board. And that made a big difference for us, just knowing that we could trust the people behind the scenes, because there's too many people in the industry that punch that card just like they're going to work, like anybody going to work, you know, punching that card, that time card. And we wanted people that still lived and loved the music and supported us and backed us. We knew we could trust, and we were able to do that, and that really stoked it.
A band of your reputation, I guess, SOiL, who've been touring around the world for years, to come to smaller towns in the UK like York, who don't traditionally get big level touring bands to come through.
As far as, it's cool. A lot of times when you play the smaller cities that don't get shows all the time, sometimes those are the coolest shows. And they come out and they're rabid and they're excited. And a lot of times those small town shows are some of your neatest and some of your most exciting shows to go to. As far as York goes personally, and I am so not saying this because it's where I'm sitting right now, but I'm going to live here someday. I've told my better half that. I've told the kids, as soon as you graduate from school, I'm out, I'm moving to York. I love this place. The last time I was here, when I came home, that's all I could talk about. Just the architecture here, the people are so nice, just walking down the street. I fell in love with this city the first time I came, and I was hoping that the lady back home lets me make the sex with her would let me bring her over this time, because this is like one of the places I really wanted to show her. And it didn't work out for us, but hopefully next time she'll come over with me and get to experience York and all the other cities we get to go see.
Absolutely, we'll hope so. And last question is, what is it that inspires you guys, maybe, or you personally, outside of music, like movies, art, anything like that? Do you have any inspirations outside of the music that you listen to?
My inspiration, probably with so much of my life, are my kids and you know, just hoping that I'm doing the right thing to secure a better life for them. And, you know, outside of music, one of the things that I really am involved with is I'm in the middle of three different books right now that I'm writing. And I have to have one done by the time that I get back to the States. I've been working on it for off and on for about 7 years now. It's just kind of like the title of it basically is, you know, the lessons learned on the path to rockstar mediocrity. You know, it's just my typical way of looking at things, flipping them off and flipping myself off at the same time. So. I'm looking forward to getting those out. Hopefully the first book, if I can make the deadline, will come out at the beginning of next year. And the next two books will follow, I hope. But that's where my time, if I'm not up there on stage or writing home, or, you know, emailing home or calling home, then I'm usually got my face on my computer writing on those things.
Fantastic. Well, good luck, Ryan, and thank you very much for your time today. I hope you enjoyed the show.
Oh, thank you very much, man. I appreciate your time as well. This is Ryan McCombs from the band SOiL, and you are watching Soundsphere.